Okay, let me If you allow me, let me explain to you how the ceremony is going to be done. First of all, I must introduce to you Mr. Jia. Mr. Jia is our father-in-law of my brother Han. Han from Boston. He's also from Boston. Both of them are in Boston. And he has the whole clan in Boston. And it's very curious that his family is also a four, P-H-O. But it's a four type, four and then P-A-I in the middle, while ours is P-H-O and then V-A in the middle. But we met him when we immigrated from the North Vietnam into South Vietnam. He was the head councilman of Saigon City, president of the council of the Saigon City before we left Vietnam. And he will officiate as the elder, the most elderly of the clan. He will officiate the celebration. What he would do, he would be lighting up two new candles, representing the new couple. He'll be lighting up these two new candles, and then he will invoke the memory of our ancestors to bless this meeting and this wedding. And then he will also use these three incense sticks to do the same thing. After that, he will present the groom and the bride to the ancestors, and he will ask them to do the same. All they have to do is to bow their head and do this. Now, chúng tôi làm trước các cháu hay là? I'm sorry. We will have to do it first. We have to present the groom and the bride to the ancestors, and then they will come up. Now, it's up to Ryan and Renee. If you want to, you may follow us. And if you don't feel comfortable, you don't have to. Good. Well, then we'll be happy so that we can register all this in the camera and send home. I'm sure.
No backing up.
I really hope and pray that when the premier of Socialist Vietnam sees this ceremony, he will come and ask us for normalization. Two countries will be very happy together.
For normalization.
Okay. Now, what's that? What's that? Chị ra. Mời chị ra, mời chị ra. Okay. After the bride and the groom have presented their respect to the ancestors, they will also present the respect to the grandfather and mother. They will do the same. They will be standing in front of them and bow their head three times to each of them. Three times to each of them. And then they'll turn to their parents and do the same. And then, of course, they will read the whole assembly. And that will end the ceremony. Then we come to the introduction of the family of the bride. Only then, after the ancestors has been given their due, we'll introduce ourselves. The bride will introduce the family of the bride to the groom, and then the groom will introduce the family of the groom to the bride, the family. And after that, of course, the ceremony will end, and we'll have our little celebration. And we'll ask you to join us somewhere in the garden. Our cameraman will be the master of this show, I would say, and he'll tell us what to do, and he'll pick the right thing so that we can send a copy to you in California and a copy to us in Hanoi. And I think that will be concluding our, of course, we have some ingredients talk. That will conclude our little ceremony. And that is very much traditional. There is also, if I want to explain to you, during this ceremony, usually they will put the jewelry on the bride. The bride will be completely bare of jewelry. Only then, whoever want to give her anything will put it on, whether an earring or a necklace or what a ring whatsoever. It's right here. But of course, since we want to wait for the earring, for the ring, wedding ring to be done in church, so we'll not do it here. But whatever else can be done here. Now that was the traditional thing, and of course we don't have to do anything that is not appropriate at this time. The only thing we need is to present them to the ancestor and to tell them to bow to their parents, to their grandparents, in thanksgiving. Instead of just say, I thank you, like we did last night, we do a gesture. And sometimes they don't have to say anything. They just, just do this, that's enough. Yes. In the Christian way, or the Jewish way, I think this is like an offering of incense. You know, I see they offer incense to the assembly. That's more or less the same thing. Okay, is the mother of bride ready? She's the always the very busy person. Ngay sau khi anh biết các cụ gái xong, anh với nhà anh gái ông bà gái xong rồi chị đến cô dâu chú rể gái. Xong đó cô dâu chú rể sẽ gái parents. Vâng.
Có cái màn có phần
anh tôn trọng vào chiều hôm nay. Chiều hôm nay có tặng vật. Ok. Bây giờ em ngồi cạnh bà đi. Okay, everybody is ready. Is the bride ready to join us in?
Yes.
So they'll be there. They have to stand right there, and they will come in right after their parents have presented the respects. Okay. See my coat. I will try to explain all this, and so that we all feel comfortable with the ceremony. And this is really not a religion. This is what we call ancestor worship, which is accepted by many other religions. Including the Buddhism, including Catholicism, whatever. We are told we can carry on this ancestor worship. I used to have a Catholic priest come here and say Mass for me during the anniversary of my father. But we'll do this after the Mass. Gentlemen and ladies in the four family.
Thưa quý vị, bên phía chú rể,
gentlemen and ladies of the large family,
ngày hôm nay tôi lấy làm hân hạnh được đại,
I am very honored,
được đại diện gia đình của ông Phó Bá Long,
to represent the family of Mr. Phó Bá Long,
trong cái ngày quan trọng. Hôm nay là ngày lễ thành hôn của cháu Lệ Thu với cháu Mai.
In this very important day of the ceremony of the wedding of our Lệ Thu and our Michael.
Chúng tôi làm lễ này trước nhất là cầu nguyện cho thiên và địa, tức là trời và đất.
We do this ceremony to pray to the heaven and the earth.
Vì con người ta sinh ra đầu đội trời, chân đạp đất.
Because we all are born, on our head is the sky and the heaven, on our feet is the earth.
Cho đến ngày nay là cái ngày thành hôn mà người Việt Nam rất là chú trọng, cho là một ngày quan trọng cho hai đời người bên cô dâu và chú rể.
Up to today is an important day in every life when in our lives the man and the wife meet each other.
Vì vậy mà thay mặt cho gia tộc họ Phó, chúng tôi trước nhất là cầu nguyện cho thiên địa.
So we representing the four families. We do the first thing is to pray the heaven and the earth.
Phò hộ cho cặp tân hôn, tân cô dâu và chú rể.
To bless the couple, the bride and the groom.
Được nhiều sức khỏe và nhiều hạnh phúc trong cái cuộc nhân duyên này.
To have good health and much happiness during their wedding life.
Sau đó, chúng tôi cũng xin cầu nguyện tất cả những tổ tiên của họ Phó về chứng kiến cuộc hôn lễ này và ban phước lành cho cô dâu và chú rể.
So after that, after praying to the heaven and the earth, we would invoke our ancestors of the four family to come back and witness this ceremony and to bless the new newlywed.
Bây giờ cuộc cúng giái sẽ bắt đầu.
Now we start our ceremony. he's orienting himself to the four cardinal points. I would pray and invoke the memory of our ancestors, especially my grandfather and my father, and my father-in-law and my mother-in-law who have passed away to witness this ceremony, to accept Michael Roach into our family, and that they may have happiness in their brother life. Mr. and Mrs. Lodge now will be presenting their respects to our parents. Thank you very much. In the name of our ancestors, we accept your greetings and we hope you much happiness. Now it's the turn of the bride and the groom. Now you will present your respects to the ancestors first, and then after that, you will present your respects to your grandparents, to your parents, and to us. You just four times. Yes, you bow four times. Greeting with your hands. Yes, okay. All right, now you turn to your grandparents, present them your respects by doing the same thing. You don't need this incense anymore.
Thank you. Come down.
Just talk to them for that. We would like to thank you. We invoke the blessings of the ancestors on you, and we hope you will come and present us with your children. The name of the lodge and the four. All right. Now you can present. First of all, Litu will have to present the people on our side to the lodge family. So present them officially to them. Just mention the name. Just mention whoever is here and present to them. First, you present.